Hi, my name is Piotr Trembecki, and today I'm going to show you the second part of designing plastic injection machine. So, let's go then.
So I'll show you what changes have I made since last video, and if you have seen the previous video, you probably see that I've modeled the clamping mechanism. So what I've used to build it is those two are standard brackets for air cylinders. They allow for it to swing. I think they call CA and CB. I'm not sure which one is which. If you look for a hardware, the air cylinder hardware, you will definitely find it. So no worries then. The plates, I've used a 15 millimeter plate. They work pretty well. The worst part is down here. I didn't model the threaded rod, which goes through that hole and the nuts hold that plate in place. So but that part tend to slightly bend when I apply force down here. Those two parts are again standard joints for air cylinders. You will need four of those, 1, 2, 3, 4, and just connect those two. That is again 15 millimeter plate, which I just made a hole and pin through there, and that's pretty much what it is. And the threaded rod down here, if you've got a lathe, no worries, but if you don't, what I've used is just bought 100 millimeter or 120 millimeter rod, just cut the head off, and there you go, you've got a threaded rod. On my machine, I've used linear bearings for to drive that plate, and here and here. Is it necessary? Well, I don't really know. It definitely helps to smooth the movement of the plate. If you don't put it, it probably wouldn't hurt in the short term. In long term, it might damage those two rails, but again, I can't tell if that's gonna be the thing. So that's pretty much it. And the changes in the injection part. Yeah, by the way, if you have any tips how to improve things, just leave the comment below. I'll be grateful for any input in that way. If you see something I'm doing definitely wrong, just let me know down in the comments. Now I've had a view down here. That's the one. That's a section view. There you go. That's the plunger, which is which ends down here. Oh, by the way, I'll explain it later. I've told you before. That's the one. Shutoff valve. You see, there is a chamfer down here. It's really important because when you use that shutoff valve, it pushes on the mold, and it tend to just slightly with time get little I don't know how to say it, and it can catch or even jump inside. So slight chamfer allows for that little don't know how to call it, for that little thing to do in there. Or you can drill halfway through with a slightly bigger drill bit. It will help as well. And that's pretty much it. That part, it's I probably told you in the previous video, it helps to push plastic outside, so it mixes better and it's more uniform temperature on the plastic, so you don't end up in the middle like plastic can be 10, 15, or 20 degrees or even more colder than on the outside. So that really helps to get a better injection, well, better parts. And down here I've used threaded rods for to hold all that injection barrel and everything. Threaded rods, I've used nuts to just lock them in position down here and down here, and they're supposed to be again springs on that threaded rod. On all four of them should be springs, so that plate can move down, but springs push them up when we don't apply force on for injection anymore. So those angle profile thingies, just you can make them a little bit longer so you can move align your cylinder and your nozzle to the molding, to the part you're molding. Yeah, let me know in the comments what do you think about that machine. If you like it, if you like to build it, I'm considering releasing those CAD files to the public domain. So let me know what you think, and I hope you learned something. I'll see you next time.